Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting SQL question. So this time we have a table called event logs with columns SessionID, timestamp and message, and the output is also the SessionID, timestamp and message, but you are seeing only one message for each and every timestamp. So just try to analyze what is the input and based on the input what is the output. So what is the logic behind this output, and what are the rules that are involved to get this output. So once you understand this is a very simple question, you can solve it. So if you are unable to understand, let's go to SQL Server Studio and see how to solve this. I will be solving this using four methods, so stay tuned till the end of the video. So this is the input as we have seen earlier. So for you have two session IDs, 1 and 2, and each and every session ID there is a timestamp and there is a message. So the output is you need to show the latest message for each and every session ID. So whatever is the maximum timestamp of that particular session ID, you need to show that particular message for each and every session ID. So hope you are clear with this. So it's a very simple question. So now let's solve this using four methods. So the first method is eventually let's use a row number function, row underscore number. So the problem is very simple, the solution is very simple using row number. So select star comma row underscore number over partition by session ID order by timestamp in descending order as rn. So just see that I'm doing this creating this assigning this row number in the descending order of the timestamp, so that the highest timestamp or the maximum timestamp will always be 1, so that it will be easy for me to filter out this row number by 1. Okay, so now if you execute this, okay, you are getting some, okay, I forgot to mention the table name, event log. So if you see the session ID timestamp of November 13th, which is the maximum date of this particular session ID. So it is assigned the row number value as 1, and for session ID 2, the maximum timestamp is October 10, which is 10:35 AM. So here if you see both the dates are same, but the time is 10:35 AM in the first one and 4:35 AM in the second. So we want the highest or the maximum timestamp. So this one is having row number 1. So now from this data set, we can simply filter with rn is equal to 1. So how do we do that? We cannot apply row number function in the where condition. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to keep this in a CTE with CTE as, okay, and select session ID comma timestamp comma message from CTE where rn is equal to 1. So if you apply this, you can simply get this output. For each and every session ID, you are getting the message which is having the maximum timestamp. So this is one way. Now the second way is using subquery or simply an inner join. Okay, so we'll do an inner join. So select from event log A, and in the inner join query, I'll use select for each and every session ID. I'll calculate the maximum of the timestamp. So session ID comma max of timestamp as mn, okay, as mn from event log, and we have to do the group by session ID, okay, and I'll keep it as alias it as b on. So if you run this, what is happening? For every session ID, you are getting the maximum timestamp here. So whatever is the maximum timestamp for that session ID, you are getting in this. So now what I'm doing with this particular subset, with this particular data set, I'm joining it with the main table event log on the session ID. Okay, on a dot session ID is equal to b dot session ID, and I'll join it with this timestamp in the event log table. I'll join the timestamp with the whatever is the maximum of timestamp we have taken here, I'll join it with that column with a dot b dot mn, and from this a dot star. Okay, so now if you run this, you will get the same output. Okay, for every session ID, you are calculating the maximum of timestamp, and for that particular timestamp and session ID combination, you are getting the retrieving the message. So in this way, you will be calculating or you will be retrieving the required output using inner join. Okay, next we will try to get it using left join or self join. Okay, so self join is nothing but joining the same table with itself. So select from event log A left join event log B on. So I'm joining the same table with itself. So first what I'll do, I'll join A dot session ID is equal to B dot session ID. So let's simply try to understand what is the output of this simple join. So if you see here, a cross join is happening for every session ID. The same session ID 1 is getting joined with each and every row in the table who is having the session ID as 1. Okay. So now what I'll do, I'll filter out the data where A dot timestamp is less than B dot timestamp. Okay. When I write this condition, what will happen? I'll get only the rows where this particular A dot timestamp is less than the B dot timestamp. Okay, so when you do this, you can see this magic over here. So I'll run this. You're filtering out everywhere where A dot timestamp is less than B dot timestamp. Okay, but you are not getting the timestamp. You are not getting all the rows. Okay, so now what we have to do? It should be in the AND condition. Okay, so in the join itself, we have to write this. Yeah. Now if you see here, each and every row is joining with the other row where the session ID is matching, and this particular first timestamp, this is the A dot timestamp, is less than the B dot timestamp. Okay, but if you see this particular row, this particular timestamp is not having any timestamp which is greater than this. Okay, that means this is the maximum timestamp. So for the maximum timestamp, there is no other you will have the B dot timestamp as null. Okay. So in this way, we'll be filtering out the maximum timestamps. So where B dot timestamp is null. So what I'm doing, I'm reiterating. So first I'm joining the same table with itself. I'm doing a left join and I'm joining it on the session ID, and I'm filtering out the data such that this particular A dot timestamp is less than B dot timestamp. Okay. So if you see here, in November 10, 4:35 is less than November 10, 10:35, and this November 10, 4:35, basically it is less than each and every particular date in this data. But November 13, 4:05 a.m. is not less than any of the timestamp for that particular session ID, because this is the maximum ID and this cannot be less than any other maximum ID. So when we apply this condition and apply a left join, we all know left join what it will happen. It will always give you the data which is present in the first table of the left join. Okay. So if you see here, this A table, whatever is the left table of the left join, it will always return rows present in the left side of the left join. Okay. But if there isn't a row matching on the right side based on the conditions, it will throw null. So the maximum timestamp will always throw null for the B dot in the second table, because you cannot have a timestamp which is the maximum timestamp will always have a blank timestamp in the B dot row. Okay, so if you run this, now we are getting let's run this. So you are getting the session ID, timestamp and message. So now I'll simply write A dot star. Okay, in this way we will get the required output using self join. Okay, now I'll write correlated subquery. So this is the fourth way. So this is also simple. So select from event log A where session ID, sorry, where timestamp is equal to, so select max of timestamp from event log B where A dot session ID is equal to B dot session ID. So if you do this, what will happen? So we are passing the timestamp. We are getting the timestamp. So here the subquery executes first. So in this, you are getting the timestamp of each and every from the you are getting the max of timestamp from the event log. You are getting in such a way that you are passing this particular a dot session id into this b dot session id. So that's why you will get two timestamps here. For each and every session id, you are getting a maximum timestamp, and this timestamp you are passing it to this particular table. Okay, so a dot star. So in this way you will get the required output. So four ways. First way is using the simple row number function, and second one is using inner join, third one is using the self join, and fourth one is using the correlated subquery. So if these kind of easy questions are asked in an interview, make sure that you are able to solve it using multiple approaches so that the interviewer will be impressed. So if you like this question and also my explanation, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.